The X6 is probably the most controversial model that BMW has ever brought us. Part luxury SUV, part sports coupe, it divides opinion, yet is sold strongly. Hence the brand's high hopes for a second generation lineup that adds a dash of maturity to this car's extrovert mix. It's sleeker, more practical and more efficient, yet it keeps in character by offering more power and astonishing dynamic prowess. In short, you'd like one. Whether anything weighing up to 2.2 tonnes and measuring over 1.7 metres in height can ever defy the laws of physics enough to match BMW's description of this model as a driver's car is another question. But there's no doubt that body control really is excellent for a vehicle of this kind. An adaptive dynamic suspension package gives you active roll stabilisation to reduce body lean through the bends, plus dynamic performance control that shifts torque between the rear wheels through any given corner, depending on where it's needed. This package can be ordered separately or combined with either adaptive comfort or adaptive M suspension packages that give you self-leveling rear air suspension to improve the ride and dynamic damper control so you can stiffen or sharpen that ride to suit the road you're on and the mood you're in. Does it all work? To a point. Ultimately, all of the various systems deliver what they set out to achieve. With the active roll system fitted, it's especially astonishing to throw this car through a set of bends and marvel at its composure. As for the speed that the road in question will disappear beneath you, well, I said earlier that I'd start by telling you about this M50D model, a storming thing that can deliver some industrial strength fireworks when you really prod it into life. Three turbos and 740 newton meters of torque, we'll see to that. Of course, as I said at the beginning, most customers will choose a rather less aggressive 3-litre diesel in their X5, namely the 258 brake horsepower unit in the xDrive 30D variant that most customers choose. There's also an xDrive 40D variant that ups the power to 313 brake horsepower, improving the sprint time to 5.8 seconds and the top speed to 149 miles an hour. As for other X6 engine choices, well, there's a 449 brake horsepower, 4.4 litre petrol V8 xDrive 50i variant that'll be a rare sight indeed on our roads, but which nevertheless is extremely fleet, demolishing the 62 mile an hour benchmark in just 4.8 seconds. The twin turbo petrol V8 fitted to the top X6M model is predictably even faster, reducing the 0 to 62 miles an hour figure to just 4.2 seconds. I should finish by talking about four-wheel drive. BMW's capable xDrive setup are non-negotiable across the range. As you would expect, it's not a system designed for mud plugging, but it's still more capable on the dirt than most owners will ever need it to be, using an electronic clutch and the cleverness of the Bavarian brand's dynamic stability control system to alter drive from the normal 40-60 front to rear bias to a situation where in milliseconds 100% of power can be pushed either to the front or to the rear as necessary. The styling of this model remains distinctively X6. That is, after all, why people like it, or at least why some people do. As for the Mark II model changes, well, look closer and they become more obvious, designed to bring the look of this car into line with its smaller X4 stablemate and collectively adding a little extra maturity to the fashionable shape. At the front, there are X-shaped contours in the bumper and, on standard models, matte silver underbody protection panels to emphasise off-piste stability. They've been colour-coordinated here. But probably more noticeable are the flatter, wider double kidney grilles, flanked by a pair of narrower headlights with distinctive LED daytime running light eyebrows. Once the rear hatch is open, you'll find yourself having to put your bags in or take them out again over a pretty high loading sill. Still, at least the cargo capacity here is reasonable, 580 litres. All well and good. Where you might be expecting problems, though, is when it comes to a seat in the rear. That sloping rear roofline has to tail somewhere, and sure enough, the really tall may well feel a little cramped. Still, BMW has contoured the roof to make the best of what's on offer, and as a result, averagely sized adults should be quite comfortable. And up front, well, the previous generation model was already very nice to sit in, but here things feel more upmarket still, with some lovely use of leather and some very high quality plastics. You sit slightly lower than you would in a conventional large luxury SUV, which accentuates the sportier feel, gripping a lovely tactile wheel through which you glance virtual instrumentation that's a model of class and clarity. With fuel savings of up to 22% over its first generation predecessor, this Mark II Model X6 deals head-on with the accusation that big SUVs carry with them big running costs. To prove the point, let me run a few numbers past you concerning the car I'm driving here, the X6 M50D. Here's a 381 brake horsepower, 2-ton luxury 4x4 that gets within a sniff of a Porsche 911 GT3 over a standing kilometre, yet can seat up to 5 people and return 42.8 miles to the gallon on the combined cycle. Emissions? This car delivers 174 grams per kilometre, which makes it nearly 50% cleaner than a rival Range Rover Sport 4.4 SD V8. It's another world. This car is an opinion divider, and probably always will be. That won't worry BMW, though. Rather than filling a niche with this X6, the Bavarian maker has instead created one, tailor-made for its approach to driving dynamics and product development. Rivals may try and copy the concept, but ultimately, there's nothing quite like this car. Of course, you'll still need to be a very individual kind of buyer to want one. Someone who thinks a bit outside the box. A rebel? Maybe not so much this time around. This second generation X6 is a slightly more mature, acceptable choice than its predecessor. Still extrovert, but a tad less in your face. In increasing numbers, the motoring public seems to love the sports activity coupe concept, proving, of course, that nothing succeeds like excess.